In this lesson, I will show you how to export a SketchUp file to AutoCAD. In the first example, I will insert a section of the model I created in SketchUp into AutoCAD. First, I have to isolate the model, so I will select it, right-click on it, and select Invert Selection. In this way, all the objects in the scene except the selected one will be selected. Then, I will right-click on the selected objects and select Hide to make them invisible from the scene. Now, I will double-click on the building to enter group editing mode. The reason I entered the editing mode is because, if I placed the section plane without entering the editing mode, the section plane would be too big. Now I will activate the Section Plane tool to place the section plane on the front view of the building. Notice that the section plane adjusts to the length and width of the building. With the Move tool active, I will move the section plane to where the staircase is. To export the view properly, I will expand the camera menu and select Parallel Projection. Then, I will change the view to Back by clicking the contextual icon that can be found in the Views toolbar. At this point, I will expand the File menu, hover the cursor over the Export option, and click on 2D Graphic. Once I click on it, the Export 2D Graphic window appears, so I can specify the name and type of the image, select a folder, and finally save the file. In this example, I will select the desktop folder and type the phrase Section 1 in the name field. Next, I will expand the Save as Type drop-down, and this time I will select the AutoCAD DWG file type. Now that I have defined the file's name and type, I will click on Options to open the export settings. From the AutoCAD version drop-down, I can select the version of AutoCAD that the file will be exported to. In this example, I will select the 2013 version. In the drawing scale and size group, you can change the scale of the model. If you have created the model in SketchUp in meters and you want to maintain the same units of measurement in AutoCAD, do not make any changes in the drawing scale and size section. As for the profile lines section, you can define how profile lines will appear, whether they will have a specific thickness, or if they will be placed in a separate layer. You have the same options about section lines. It is advisable that the line thickness be edited in AutoCAD. Finally, you have the option to display the extension lines if you enable the Show Extensions option. Personally, I will not make any changes to any of these settings, and I will click OK. Finally, to export the file to AutoCAD, I will click Export. To see the result, I will minimize SketchUp and open the AutoCAD file I just created. In the message that appears, choose to open the AutoCAD file. Now, we can see the section in AutoCAD. The section lines and profile lines have also been placed in different layers. Following the same procedure, you can export your three-dimensional model to an AutoCAD file. To do that, I will maximize the SketchUp file and delete the section plane. In addition, I will expand the camera menu and change the view back to perspective. Next, I will expand the file menu, hover the cursor over the export option, and click on 3D model. Notice that the file types are now different, and they are all types that are compatible with 3D design programs. The most common types are 3DS file, which are files that are compatible with 3D Studio Max, AutoCAD files, and objects, which are compatible with almost all 3D design programs. In this case, I will select the AutoCAD option. Then I will click Options to open the export settings. From the AutoCAD version drop-down, I can select the version of AutoCAD that the file will be exported to, and right below, I can select what will be exported. I can export faces, edges, construction geometry, dimensions, materials, and text objects. Since I want to export only the surfaces of the model, I will select only the face option and click OK. Lastly, I will export the file and open it with AutoCAD. In general, this procedure might take quite some time since a 3D model is more complex than a 2D view. If an error appears, click OK. Once it's open, you can see the result and even start working on the model through AutoCAD.